students, today we have to see the problems. First of all, we go to problems based on solubility. Solubility means you know very well what is meant by solubility. Solubility is nothing but gram of solute. That is gram of solute that can be dissolved in 100 gram of solvent to form a saturated solution at a given temperature and pressure. There is a formula. Solubility is equal to mass of solute into 100 divided by mass of solvent. See here, mass of solute into 100 divided by mass of solvent. Okay, in a solution, whenever it may be, the little amount is known as solute and the higher amount is known as solvent. Okay, first sum, we go to first sum. See here, first sum, 1.5 gram of solute is dissolved in 15 gram of water to form a saturated. See here, to form a saturated solution at 8 Kelvin. Find out the solubility of a solute at that temperature. So, solubility is, you know very well, mass of solute into 100 divided by mass of solvent. Here, solute is 1.5 gram and the solvent is 15 gram. Okay, now you substitute the value 1.5 into 100 divided by 15 equal to 150 divided by 15 equal to 10 gram. Always solubility is given in grams, so 10 gram. 10 gram of solubility, 10 gram is solubility. Okay, next we go to next sum. Okay, see here, next, find the mass of potassium chloride would be needed to form a saturated solution in 60 gram of water at 303 Kelvin. Given the solubility of KCl is 37 divided by 100 gram at this temperature. Now you know very well, mass of potassium chloride in 100 gram of water is 37 gram. See here, how much? 37 gram. So mass of potassium chloride in 60 gram, 100 gram they given, we have to calculate for 60 gram. So mass of potassium chloride in 60 gram of water in saturated solution is equal to 37 divided by 100 into 60. So you get 22.2 gram. Okay, 22.2 gram is the solubility of sodium chloride, potassium chloride. Next sum, third sum. What is the mass of sodium chloride that would be needed to form a saturated solution in 50 gram of water at 30 degree centigrade? They given solubility of sodium chloride is 36 gram at 30 degree centigrade in 100 gram of water. Whenever they given, that are belongs to 100 gram. So 100 gram of water they given 36 gram. You have to find out for 50 gram of water. So mass of sodium chloride is dissolved in 100 gram of water is 36 gram. So mass of sodium chloride that would be needed to 100 gram of water is equal to 36 gram. So you have to find out for 50 gram. So mass of sodium chloride dissolved in 50 gram of water. See here, 50 gram of water is equal to 36 into 50 divided by 100. So 18 gram is needed for the 15 gram of water to get a saturated solution. Okay, next we go to fourth question. See here, fourth question. The solubility of sodium nitrate 50 degree and 30 degree. 50 degree is 114 and the 30 degree is 96 gram respectively. Find the amount of salt that will be thrown out when the saturated solution of sodium nitrate containing 50 gram of water is cooled from 50 to the temperature will be lower to 50 to 30 degree Celsius. First of all, you find out amount of sodium nitrate dissolved in 50 gram of water. See here, amount of sodium nitrate that is dissolved in 50 gram of water at 50 degree Celsius equal to 114 into 50 divided by 100 equal to 57 gram. So now we find out at 50 degree centigrade. Next we go to find out at 30 degree centigrade. Similarly, amount of sodium nitrate is dissolved in 50 gram of water at 30 degree Celsius is 96 into 50 divided by 100 equal to 48 gram. Now we have to subtract the value amount of sodium nitrate thrown when the 50 gram of water is cooled from 50 degree to 30 degree Celsius. That is 57 minus 48 equal to 9 gram. Okay, next topic is based on mass percentage. Already we know the formula, mass percentage is equal to mass of solute divided by mass of solution. That solution contains solute plus solvent. Okay, first sum we go to. A solution was prepared by dissolving 25 gram of sugar in 100 gram of water. Calculate the mass percentage of solute. Here mass of solute is equal to 25 gram. See here sugar. Okay, next mass of solvent is equal to 100 gram. So mass percentage is equal to mass of solute divided by mass of solution into 100. Mass percentage is equal to mass of solute is 25 gram and the mass of solution is equal to mass of solute plus solvent. So 25 plus 100 into 100. Okay, 25 divided by 125 into 100. So equal to how many percentage means you have to divide this one. So here 125, here 2500, you divided means you get 20%. How many percentage? 20%. So 20% is mass percentage of the solution. Okay, next we go to 16 gram of NaOH is dissolved in 100 gram of water at 25 degree centigrade form a saturated solution. Find the mass percentage. Here mass of solutes equal to, see here mass of solutes equal to 16 gram and the mass of the solvent is equal to 100 gram. So mass percentage you know very well, mass of solute divided by mass of solute plus solvent. So 16 into 100 divided by 16 plus 100 equal to 1600 divided by 116. That is equal to, see here, that is equal to 13.79%. Mass percentage of solvent, you have to calculate the solvent equal to 100 minus mass percentage. Already we calculated the solute, that is 13.79. You subtract from 100, you get 86.21%. It is the mass percentage of solvent. Okay, next sum. Find the amount of urea which is to be dissolved in water to get 500 gram of 10% W by W aqueous solution. They given the mass percentage, that is 10% is the directly they give the mass percentage. So mass of solute divided by mass of solvent, you have to calculate the mass of solute, that is urea. Mass of solute is here urea. So mass percentage is equal to mass of solute divided by mass of solution into 100. Solution they given 500 gram. Okay, mass percentage is equal to 10. 10 is equal to mass of urea divided by 500 into 100. So you get, take to the mass of the urea to the left hand side and 10 to the right hand side. So you get the formula. See here, mass of urea is equal to, divided by 100. Okay, so 5 times 5 into 10 is equal to 50. So 50 gram of urea is wanted to soluble here. Okay student, this session will be over. Tomorrow we have to see the another sums.